Hi, Dan Finkel here from Math for Love. I've got a really interesting exploration to share with you today that can also become an art project if you want it to. So I'm gonna dive right in and then show you where it can go. So I've got some circles here. I've got 10 dots in a circle, 11 dots in a circle, 12 dots in a circle. And I wanna kind of imagine that I'm just gonna play a little game where it's almost like I'm throwing a ball between people or just connecting the dots. Like if there are people throwing a ball between them, connecting the dots, and I'll connect every, I don't know, let's do every third dot I'll connect. So I think about this as being like a jump rule. So I'm gonna jump, I'm gonna pick a dot to start with, doesn't matter which one, and then I will jump one, two, three, I'll jump to three dots away. One, two, three, cool. And then I'll do another one, two, three. Very nice. And I'll just keep going, one, two, three. And as I'm going, a question immediately pops out at me, which is, if I just keep doing this, you have to be a little careful to make sure you're not missing any. If I keep doing this, will I hit every point? And it looks like I get back to where I started. And then if I keep going, I'll just repeat the same path again and again. So I'm kind of done. That's the shape I've made. It's pretty cool. I've hit all the dots, and it's made a really beautiful shape known as a star polygon. So that was a jump rule of three with 10 dots. I wonder if the jump rule of three will always hit all the dots in the circle. I mean, I could try different jump rules, right? And I could try a different number of dots. And really, this is just a place to experiment and say like, oh, if I change the number of dots in the circle, and if I change my jump rule, what happens? Let's try 11 dots with a jump rule of three again and see what happens. So I'll pick some dot. I'm gonna go to every third dot and I go one, two, three, 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 one, two, three. And I just keep doing that same jump rule. Again, a star polygon, similar to the other one, hits everything, very nice. As I'm doing this, I almost can't help but start to come up with conjectures. And a conjecture I might have now is every time I have a jump rule of three, it's gonna hit every dot in my circle. It's a super natural conjecture to come up with. I've gotten some examples, seems like it might be true, but as soon as I have a conjecture, I always need to see if I can break it. And so I'm gonna keep testing it. Maybe I'll test it on 10, or on 12, excuse me. So I'll pick a dot and I'll go one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. Oh, now I'm back here. I just got a square. So right away, my conjecture is false. A jump rule of three doesn't always work to hit all the dots. For this one, it didn't work. So I don't know, then I may have a new conjecture based on playing around with this more, and I can try drawing more dots. I've got some templates that you can use if you'd like to use that. And you can also make more physically sturdy versions of these. They're very pretty and they make a really cool art project. And I can just keep trying. You know, I could say, well, what if I did like in blue a jump rule of four? You know, would that hit everyone on 10, 11, or 12, or 9, or 13, or anything else I want to try? If I try for 10, I go 1, 2, 3, 4, and I go to there. 1, 2, 3, 4, go to there. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, that's interesting. It's a little busy. I might want to start with another one, but it looks like I make a five-pointed star there with the jump rule of four. So I didn't hit everything with four either. I had another conjecture that broke that one also. Interesting. This is something for you to try and explore. More ideas on how to use this are below this video. All right, enjoy.